It's that time of year where after Christmas we sit down and watch the top teenage hockey nations on the planet go at it in the IIHF Ice Hockey World U20 Championships. Or as everyone else knows them as, the World Juniors. As the name goes, this is a junior tournament, so only players under or at the age of 20 can participate. Specifically, the player has to have their 20th birthday in the year that the tournament ends in. This means that to participate in the 2018 World Juniors, a player would have to be 20 or younger in the year 2018. Which would mean that they would have to have been born in 1998. The minimum age to participate in the tourney is 5 years from the maximum age, meaning that the youngest a person can be to participate is someone with a birth year in 2003. Although this rule is almost like a technicality to have a minimum age, since there isn't ever really a time where a team will choose to ice a 15-year-old, as most teams will try to get players close to that age of 20 as possible. For the last few requirements designated for players in the tournament, they're pretty self-explanatory. First, a player needs to be male. Next, the player needs to be a citizen in the country he represents. And finally, the player needs to be under the jurisdiction of a national association that is part of the IIHF. This pretty much means that the team you represent needs to be part of the IIHF. And if you're already playing in the World Juniors, then you've already met that requirement, so there's no worrying there. Now for the teams themselves, ever since 1996, the tournament has increased in participation from 8 teams to 10 teams. These 10 teams are split into 2 groups of 5 apiece. Once each team in each group plays each other, the top 4 teams in both groups move on to the playoffs, while the 2 last place teams in each group play a relegation round. For the playoffs, the best team in Group A will play the 4th best team in Group B, the 2nd place team in Group A will play the 3rd best team in Group B, and so on and so forth. They all play in single elimination games where the winner moves on to the next round. The losers of the semifinals play in the bronze medal game, while the winners of the semis play in the gold medal game. Now going back to that relegation round that I mentioned earlier, those 2 last place teams play in a best of 3 series where the winner of the series gets to return to next year's World Junior Tournament, and the loser is relegated to the IIHF's Division 1 Group A, which is pretty much a lower tier. The standings of each team, which are decided by their goals, tournament placement, and points granted by wins and OT wins, are used to place the teams into groups for the next year's World Juniors. But since the tournament has 10 teams, we're still missing one more team for the next World Junior Championships, because as of now we only have 9. Well, for that final 10th team, a separate tournament is held. Remember how I mentioned that a team that gets relegated from the World Juniors moves down to the Division 1 Group A? Well, the tiers below that are Division 1 Group B, then Division 2 Group A, Division 2 Group B, Division 3 Group A, and finally Division 3 Group B. Each of these groups play amongst themselves, and then the winners of their respective groups get promoted to the group higher above, while the last place teams in these groups get relegated to a lower spot. This means that the last spot in the next World Junior Tourney is given to the top team in Division 1 Group A. And for those wondering, the teams that play in the World Juniors are referred to as the top division. And so that more or less covers who plays in the IIHF Ice Hockey World U20 Championships. I hope you liked the video, and I'll see you in the next one.